The cons: it's very subjective. You're probably going to get a lot of information that may be contradictory. One organization or one department may think that a web defacement is the worst thing that could possibly happen, while another department thinks that divulging confidential data is the worst thing that can possibly happen. So you will have to rank and evaluate based on the input source. Also, there's no associated cost of losses and controls. One thing that you lose in a purely qualitative risk assessment is the ability to say, I'm going to lose $100,000 if this risk occurs, and it's going to cost me $20,000 to control it. You have to be a little careful about not spending more than you're actually getting back. And it's very difficult to automate the process. There's no spreadsheet that's going to make this one easy. Let's take a look at an example. The source would be the particular organization that provided the input. We have the development organization, IT management, operations management, and system administrators. In each case, they evaluate a risk. Let's assume that the risk is a hacker breaking in and stealing sensitive data. Well, the development group may think that's not a big deal, not very severe, while your operations managers and your system administrators think it's a huge deal. Secondly, ask each organization, what's the likelihood that a specific threat could occur? How would you control it? Now, in this case, in a real qualitative risk assessment spreadsheet, I would probably create more than just one particular control. Ask the development managers, how many different ways could we control this threat? And how effective is each method? In this case, for the sake of brevity, I broke it all down into a single control. Development may think that a honeypot is the best way to control someone breaking in. IT management and operations thinks that firewall is the best way to do it. System administrators look at it that it's an IDS system.